your initiation has been given to serve Krishna. You have been admitted in the class of initiation. You have not received initiation. Try to understand. You have been admitted in the class of association. Diksha means the Dibyagan, transcendental knowledge. You have not received, but you should try to have transcendental knowledge for your guru from other devotees. No? You have come in the process, but actually not diksha. Only fire sacrifice will not give diksha. You should follow and practice like this. And cha, cha means, oh, like a skalan, like washing. All bad your activities, bad practices, unwanted things, anartha, sinful activities, are washed by this process. But it is still not washed. We have come in this process. So try to follow all these things, then you will have diksha. I know so many disciples, they take initiation from Gurudev, bona fide Gurudev. Then why they go down? Actually, they don't try to follow the processes. They think that we have received diksha, but actually that is not diksha, external diksha. Try to have real internal diksha, and it may take some day, some years for this, for transcendental knowledge. And if you are not taking all this, then you will be weak. Being brahmachari for 10, 20, 15 years, and you will again go to, again, same mice. Puro masika. You know this mice? Mouse. Don't be mouse. Try to go up. So, this is admitting in class, like. You are all in this class. Don't think that we have awfully initiated. You are still in class. And when it will be perfect, oh, then very good devotee. Then no fear to fall and to be weak. So try to follow all these things. Now we are giving class for diksha, that you should follow all these things. Ajnanatimirandhasya jnananjanasalakaya chakshurunumilitam jena tasmai Sri Gurave vancha kalpatarubhyasya kripa-sindhubhyeva cha patitanam pamanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo mahabhadannaya krishna prema pradayate krishnaya krishna chaitanya namne gauratishe gurave gaurachandraya radhikaya tadalaye krishnaya krishna bhaktaya tadabhaktaya namo yam prabrajantam anupetam apet krityam dvaipayano virahaka taraya juhava putreti tanmetaya tarvo vinedu tam sarvabhutaridayam tavai vasmi najivami tvaya vina iti vigyairadhe tanne mam chara bhaktya vihinaya parada lakshaya kshiptasya kamadi taranga kripamayin kvam saranam prapanna vinde maste charana. So Srimad Bhagavatam, Dashama Skanda, 38th chapter. Now Krishna has finished his pastimes in Braja. When he killed Keshi and Bhimasur, Narad came and prayed that you should remember that you'll have to do so many things. Now we are very much churned in Vrindavan Leela pastimes. And you have forgotten that your Mathura father and mother are in the jail of Kans. And Kans is what, making so much nonsense and problems, always insulting, crushing with his boats. And after that, you know that you have promised to marry with 16,108 devotees in Dwarka. You'll have to save and protect Pandavas also. They are big problem. And they are Saranagat to you only. Duryodhana is making so many problems. Problems and problems. He had taken his kingdom. They have been driven to
forest.
So, also you will have to. Oh, you have promised that you will have to finish all the demons. There are so many demons now. Those who were killed in Ram Lila in Lanka, all have come like Kshatriya kings. And they are so much burden to this earth. Also, there are so many things. So, you should remember this. Only not be involved in Vrindavan. Krishna told, oh, you have remind me, and now you can go. Everything will go up. Then Krishna decided something. Here, one day, he was in Prem Sarovar between Nandagaon and Varshana. Do you remember? Prem Sarovar. One day, Radha and Krishna, with all the gopis, they were sitting on the bank of very beautiful Prem Sarovar. Oh, the scenery was so high class of beautiful. All kinds of flowers were in bosom. And cuckoo birds were singing, so many peacocks dancing there, surrounding by lakhs and lakhs Kamdhenu cows. And there, in their council, Lalita Abhishaka, all the Ashta Sakhi, especially Nandi Mukhi, Vrinda Devi, Dhanishta, and so many prominent Sakhis were there. Srimati Radhika was in the lap of Krishna, being like one. Krishna has given his hands, and Radhika also like that. And a bamboo became, and he thought that the lotus feet of Radhika is actually a lotus, very fragrant, sweet. And he was coming to taste some honey from that lotus. And he was doing hemming and wanted to enter in that lotus. Radhika feared, so soft, so feared. And we like this. Madhumangal at once came from anywhere with a bamboo stick. And he was doing like this, and he drove away that bamboo waste very far away, and he returned and told, "I've driven this bamboo, Madhusudan, and he will never come again. So don't fear." And hearing Srimati Radhika, the name of Madhusudan, Madhusudan has so many meanings, one name of Krishna. Why Madhusudan? The love of gopis are madhu like honey, and Krishna testing it. So it is Madhusudan. Another meaning of Madhusudan is that madhu, worldly desires,
attachment
to all these things. The lust of wife, husband, children, and all like this. This is like honey. But Krishna can cut off all this. So he is Madhusudan. Sudan means to cut away. If he will do Madhusudan, he will cut all things, all bad desire, attachment. So he is Madhusudan. And he always takes and tests the honey of the gopis' love and affection. So he is Madhusudan. Also so many meanings, but prominent too. So Madhumangal came and told that, "Oh, I've driven out this Madhusudan forever. He will never return." And just Srimati Radhika heard this and became unhappy. And he thought, Madhusudan has gone. He was in the lap of Krishna. But now he was so much weeping. Where Krishna Madhusudan has gone? He will never come. Then how can I live? Then I will die. Without Madhusudan, I cannot live. And she forget herself. And she forget that I am in the lap of Krishna. And weeping, and she becomes senseless, totally. Krishna saw very strange thing. She is in my lap, and she has forgotten everything. What is this? Prema Vaichitya. And more than this, Dibyunmad, and more this, Madan mood. In meeting, she feels separation. It is only for Radhika, not for anyone, even not for Lalita Vishakha. What to tell Chandravali? Highest class of. In meeting, separation also, fullest separation, and fullest meeting. But forgetting everything. Very high class thing. Krishna is saying that if Srimati Radhika is nearer to me, that where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? For future separation, she becomes senseless. I cannot help. But if I am not here, then going deep in separation mood, and she remembers Krishna, and see that, this tamal is Krishna. Not thinking that's this tamal, but we are thinking like tamal. But she used to think that, Krishna is here. He makes his dresses very, takes sringar, and speaks with him, where you are? And then he does man to Krishna. Even in man, in separation also man. Very strange thing. And now she is weeping. So what to do? How to console? I cannot console. This is a very big problem for me. Whenever I come and be with Radhika, for future separation she becomes like so. I cannot help. And if I am not here, then feeling some separation, and he goes in deep in separation, and he sees that, clouds are there. Then, clouds, like, Krishna, don't come to me. Or clouds. No? So she struggles with her,
braid.
That they are black. So always like this. In separation something. Say I can sleep. Say I can do anything. Some happiness. But in meeting, always so much high class of separation mood. So Krishna is thinking, what to do? So I must be some far away. Otherwise, they will be always unhappy. That is why he is thinking, oh, I should be some far away. To give some relief to them. And if I am here, always they will feel separation. Always weeping, always senseless, always this thing. That is his thought, that I should be out of pleasure. Otherwise I cannot
satisfy them.
Help them. There will be more feeling separation. You cannot realize these things. Only you should hear something. You can hear something. So, Krishna decided that I should come in dream. I should come in manifestation. Like, in other way I should come. But not directly. If I will directly come, then they will be unhappy. Their stage is so high of Madan and Modan, more than Narudha Devu. So, to pacify gopis, he decided this, that I should be fire. And that is why he is not again coming. If coming, then how it becomes? If any, there is cut, and if you are giving some lemon on this cutting, how it become? More. If you practice love and affection like this, in high class of issues, you can realize something. Something. And then, you will so be attached in pastimes of Krishna, you will realize, and then nothing this to this worldly thing. Nothing. No problem at all. Always happy. And when you see Srimad Bhagavatam, any of his, you will sing so deep. So now, Krishna is thinking, I will have to make something. If I am here, then I am giving so much problem for gopis. They will be unhappy more. So he was thinking how to do. In the meantime, Kansa was thinking, how to kill Krishna and Baldev? He made so many
plans.
But all plans were in hell. And they were killed. At last he called Akrur. Akrur was his like uncle. And he told that, oh, you are a qualified person. I know that you have so much attachment to me. And you have also some relation to Krishna and Baldev. So I think that you should help me. I'm going to arrange an arena here near Rangeshwar temple. And there we'll make so many interesting
wrestling
and all so many things. And then Krishna Baldev will come and we'll surround him. And all we will kill him, Krishna. So go at once. Akrur was Parambhakta. He has faith in Krishna, that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. He has come to kill Kansa and all demons. He became very happy. I must go there. And I will see Krishna. Will he remember me like any servant? Then I will be so fortunate. And thinking that anyhow, Kansa has given me fortune to go to Krishna. I will take darshan of Krishna and I will pray something. And that he went there. But what is in the root of all these things? Krishna wish Yogamaya came and give this thought where? In the mind of Kans and also in Kakrur. So Krishna plan was there. Now he is making something, arrangement to go some far away from Vrindavan to pacify Gopis. Then Akrur came in a golden chariot. Krishna, Kans gave him his own chariot. Here, Vasudev, Devaki and Maharaj Ugrasen were put in jail. Very thick chain they were painted so that they can, and very strong cords were there. And he wanted that when Krishna will come here and Baldev, we will call all devotees also, Nanda, Vasudev, Devaki, Ugrasen, and in front of them we will kill Krishna. They will see that I am Kansa. I can kill. And then they will feel separation and they will be killed themselves. So planning this, Akrur went there. And he met with Krishna and Baldev. In the way he saw the footprints of Krishna. If you have gone to Nandagaon, there is Yacharan Pahadi, still having the footprints of Krishna. Very beautiful. He saw that lakhs and lakhs footprints were in the dust of Braja near Nandagaon. Krishna always going with cowherd, empty feet. And she fell down on the lotus feet of Krishna. And he was praying. His heart was melting. Tears coming, hair standing. And he prayed so many things. It is written in Srimad Bhagavatam. What a your idea. He was very high class of Vaishnava, of Dasya Rasa. Then he met with Krishna and Baldev and told secretly, do you know that you are son of Devaki and Vasudev? Now they are in jail. And this demon Kans is torturing them. Only for you, no reason other. That they have sent you to Gokul. And that is why they are torturing. Then they became furious. Oh, for me, I must go there. And then return back. So he made up his mind. And he told to father, Nanda Baba. Nanda Baba agreed. There were some arguments, logics, that Krishna should go there. Otherwise, Kans will be torturer to also to Nanda and Yashoda and all Brajavasi. So by fear, they were agreed. In the meantime, in the morning, in the evening, same evening, it was declared everywhere on drum that tomorrow Nand Baba and other gops with some friends of Krishna, they will take Baldev and Krishna. They will go to Mathura and there they will see the arena, the fighting of wrestling things. And then they will return back. It was all were like happy, like friends were happy that we are also going and we will see new things. Nanda Baba, he was not in fear because I am going with Krishna and Baldev and I will bring them again. All the gopis were like this. They were not lamenting or feeling separation. Yashoda Maiya, Nanda Baba told that you should be without any fear. What? Nirbhay ka kya hota angreji? दा ये भी नहीं होता कोई अप्रोप्रिएट वर्ड ये शुड बी निर्भय डोंट फियर ओ आई एम गोइंग एंड आई विल अगेन ब्रिंग देम नथिंग टू फियर यशोदा थॉट दैट ओह ही इज गोइंग विद देम सो ही विद देम आई विल रिटर्न बट गोपीज हु गोपीज द बिलवड ऑफ कृष्णा They were thinking in other mood. They were abusing Brahma, creator. What they are telling? He is very cruel. Krishna is so sweet. And anyhow, this creator made a chance to meet Krishna. And just we are going to meet, but he is so cruel that he took fortune and again he made separation. At once we are going to taste that sweetness, but at once he took away. He is not qualified to make this world. All the beauties of the whole world, three worlds, he took and made the beautiful body of Krishna. So how looking? Everything so threefolded. Some holes in here, no? Beautiful holes. Smiling so beautiful like arrows. His everything is crooked. His words are also having sweetness crooked. He is looking crooked. It penetrates in the hearts of those who are looking after. So we have chance, but this cruel creator, like a baby boy, they make from dhool se, dust any fence. Like, oh, this is my Royal Palace. And again they
destroy.
So Brahma is like that. He gets chance to meet Krishna. He gave all this sweetness and beauties of whole three world in Krishna. But at once when we meet and at once he quickly take this fortune. So he is very cruel, very cruel. This cruel has come here in shape, that Vidhata. Who Vidhata? Who created this beauty and get this chance? Now he has come in the shape of? He is actually crude. Crude means?
Cruel.
But he has taken the name of? Oh, crude, that I am not crude. But actually, very crude, very crude. They are weeping, not hearing that we are laughing now, but not there. They are telling all these things from their heart, feeling separation. Oh, he has come here, and we were testing, we are going to test, like, if any dish, very beautiful, tasteful dish comes, and we were going to take it, but in the meantime, anyone came and took. Monkeys from Vrindavan came, and they took at once and went on tree. And you are looking, what happened? So this cruel, Nistur Akrur came, and he took Krishna, our beloved. How can we live? We cannot live. They become like a fish out of water. Are you in this state? We are not. So Krishna is very far away from us. From then, Krishna is there, always with them. Try to be in this state. This is our object. How you can be? If you are dividing and dividing and dividing and dividing your attachment to Krishna too, worldly, wives, son, daughters, all these things, how you can do? Krishna gave you only alone your birth. You came in this world. And Krishna told in the womb of your mother, be alone. I am giving this birth only for what? Practicing bhakti yoga. Don't make any friend, boyfriend, girlfriend, sister, mother, anything. Try to become like Bharat in third birth. But we promise there that we will never be dual. But when we came, sister took me in her lap. And, baby. And he made a sister. He made a mother. He made a father. He made a others. Whole community. Never. Mother, sister, father. And then he gradually became in young age and he met 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 girlfriends or boyfriends. Krishna is demanding something, coming in the shape of Guru Vaishnav, warning, giving. But, I'm doing, after this, I will not do this. I will give up all these things. This is our life. Again, some vibes come. Try to realize this. And when you'll die alone. Alone. To whom you have given so many, your whole energy, they will not remember you for a moment. They cannot help you. You must know all these things. Gopiras are telling these things. They are very expert. They never divided their love and affection to anyone in this world. They took from husband, sisters, brothers, fathers, everything. Gradually they took. If you want to love Krishna, gradually you will have to be. And if you are not doing, then at the time of death, you will be kicked like donkeys from behind legs. And you will be burnt into ashes. Surely you should know that anyone cannot help. Only Krishna can help his mother. So you should try to realize all these things. This is association. Take something from this association and return with so many things. Take some love and affection from this association. This will help you. So gopis are telling. This is Srimad Bhagavatam. So many things more we will give you. So many gopis. Then gopis are telling like this. Now they blame first to Vidhata, to Creator. And then who? That Creator came in the shape of? Now they are blaming to Krishna. There is no blame of Vidhata or Akrur or anything. Krishna is always, Navasanga Priya. Navasanga Priya Manaki. New. He is never satisfied with old one. Like a bumblebee, he goes to any very beautiful lotus and taking the sweetness, again goes to another. Sometimes he become mad that, and even to bad flowers, smelling flowers, there is no mother other that he can see. Because this is new. So Krishna is like this. His blacklist also like that. He never satisfied with, old one. So he now wants to test some new thing. That is why. Krishna, this is the motive of Krishna, that is, he is leaving us and he is going to Mathura. And he will be very happy. Now he is with us, we are only the girls of village. Not so beautiful. We cannot attract anyone. What I should tell? With a bell like this, so many sweet words, with some shame, very attractive. They can pose Very beautiful, all these things. But we are not like that. We cannot play like them. So they are very expert because they are interns. And they can make up so much. They can decorate their host with lipsticks and so many things. But we cannot, we don't know all these arts. Then when Krishna will go and they will do like this, Krishna will be so much attached. And there are not only 1, 2, 3, 4, lakhs and lakhs. He will have a love to this, to that, to that, to that, that, to that. And he will be engaged and he will never return. We know. And they began to lament so much. We know the habit of Krishna. He is going. But we are fear that he will never return. Oh, this night, after this night, very beautiful Suprabhat will come. What? Good morning will come. All the ladies and all the persons, Jadav, Vaishni, Bhoj, all will be very happy and they will tell that good morning, because they will have, they will see the face of Krishna, beautiful Krishna. Kya ho gaya? So, what? Very best. Morning for Mathura Vasi. All will have chance to see all the beautiful essence of the whole world, all beauties. And they will see Krishna. And Krishna will talk with them. He will attach to them. And for us, today night is like Kaljam. Like that. Tomorrow in morning, we cannot see Krishna. How dangerous. Then all we will die. All the birds and peacocks and all animals will die. All the cows, what will be of the cows? They will not graze. They will only see towards Krishna. They will also die. Then what will this Vrindavan? It will be a barren land only. So, Akrur is very cruel. In Mathura there will be daily so Mahatsav, always Mahatsav. And in Vrindavan? No, nothing. It will be barren land. Now, we are wondering, we are astonished that there are so many old persons here. They are think to be very intelligent like Upananda and all others, the brothers of Nanda Baba and others, so many old persons. But we now thinking that they are not intelligent. Why they are not stopping Nanda? Not to take Krishna and Baldev to there. And send Akrur alone. Krishna should be sent. But not they are telling anything. They are accepting this proposal of Nanda Baba and Akrur. Then what to do? Then we'll have to be out of shame. We will ourselves, we will go and tell Nanda Baba and Jashoda Maiya, you are so cruel. Don't send this Krishna to with cruel. Krishna will never return, I mean, no. So we will try. Let us go and tell to Jashoda Maiya and others. In the meantime, it became morning. And Akrur did his sandhya. And then he brought that very chariot. And he began to go on that chariot, taking Krishna and Baldev. Gopi were, they at once came and they checked the chariot. They became some of them. Srimati Radhika Singh, very far away, she became senseless. And other gopis who have some senses, they came and they took the rein of horses, lamenting. Some fell down, rolling down there on the front of chariot and some were beating. But Akrur was so cruel that anyhow he wanted to take Krishna to Mathura. And Krishna some admission has given. So Krishna told to all the gopis who were incensed by his eyes, "I will come very soon. I will kill Kans today or tomorrow, and then I must return." He promised there with a dautakai. What is daut?
Messenger.
What were messenger? The eyes. And he told to someone gopis who were insensate, "Oh, tell this message to all gopis, especially to Radha who is not incensed, that day after tomorrow I must return." And quickly, anyhow, Akrur, he kept some stake on the horses and in crooked way and went. And all gopis were in pain. Those who were not faint, they were seeing the dust of and also dust waves come. They never returned to Nandagaon. They were in forest. When Akrur came, he met them. Very pathetic scene they came. Uddhav came. Then Krishna, all were gopis, were only thinking that we should die, but we should not die. Why? If Krishna will return, because he has told that I will return, so it is certainly that if Krishna has done promise, he must come. We have faith on his words. So he will come. And when he will come, and if you are dying, then he will see that, oh, all gopis have died, then he will die. So we must not die. We should tolerate any kind of separation, any kind of fire. We are burning in fire, even separation fire. But we'll have to keep our life. Only for Krishna. That Krishna will come and see. So gopis, 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5, 10, 50, but Krishna never returned. Why? Sometimes Krishna may come in the shape of bumblebee, sometimes in this way, sometimes in dream, sometimes in any manifestation. He comes and sees gopis. And they think that, oh, we are seeing Krishna in dream. Actually, he has not come. Sometimes they become so deep in love, they never think that Krishna has gone to Mathura. Krishna is here. He has gone to cow grazing. And in the time of evening, Yashoda takes his arti plate, everything ready, that Krishna is coming, Baldev is coming. But whole night she may stand there. Krishna never comes. Now no cooking, nothing. Now no bird singing. What is the condition of Braj, you can imagine. I may tell a worldly story. I was in Italy. Where? In the ocean beach.
We went for walking on the beach of the
ocean.
In Italy.
Oh, we were in car, oh, 4 or 5 persons only.
Three.
Oh, when I walked and I was coming, our car was there. A very beautiful old dog came there. His eyes were full of mud and some weeping signs were there. And I saw that. He at once came to us. And he
smelled.
And then he was looking very pathetically to us. I looked to that. And when another car came and stopped, he went there. And he was looking. And again sad. I told to them that it seems that this dog was formerly to any good person. And he was very like Alsatian dog, very good dog. I asked them, why he is waiting for all the cars they are coming. They told that this dog belongs to any rich person. And for several years he was with him. His master used to keep him in his car when going and giving bath, always having so much love and affection for dog. So many years went on. And he was so much happy there, always having his master with us. After some time, he became to be old. And one day he came to that beach, and he saw any beach, when a dog, sea dog. And he came from the car, and he went to that, with that car. And also, now he was old, the master thought that I will have to take a new one. And what I will do of this? She left him, and quickly started his motor and went to his room, his house. Never cared for that, he neglected for that. Now dog, after some time he returned and he was looking after his master. Where my master? Where master? Searching in all cars here and there. No taking anything. Nothing. Always searching his master. Whenever any car passes, he goes there. And it became like 1 year, 2 years. But his master never returned. And he's looking out, always. There is none to wash his mud's tears, not to give anything. And he was always weeping for his master, seeing that, my master must come. And that is his living, that one day, today, my master will come, waiting me. If a dog can do like this, his master may be cruel, but Krishna may not be cruel. If dog is remembering his master, how? That he will come, just now come, perhaps he is coming. And he go and see that, this is my not master. Then he becomes to weep and becomes sad. And he sits, and again, with hope he is waiting for. If a dog can do, why we cannot do? This is the, like some shadow of comparison to gopis. Why gopis are lamenting? This dog may remember that one day my master took me in his lap and he was washing with hands and giving the sweet thing what he was going to take and he was giving me. Sometimes he used to take me in his bed also, always so perceptive. Remembering this and his weeping, so a devotee can be like this, always remembering the past. So gopi, always remembering the past times of Krishna, how Krishna was dancing with me, how Krishna used to give his betel nut in our mouths, how he loved us. Sometimes dancing and singing with gopis. I can sing in fifth tune, but gopis in seventh. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. And he used to praise us. But now who will praise? remembering and repeating. This is Ashtakaliya Leela life. Devotee can remember all these things, and then mind will not go here and there. Krishna is telling that you should remember. Gopis are laughing to Krishna. Very sad. Oh, we want to forget you, but we cannot forget you. All remembrance coming, like a chain coming, and want to forget you. If you can forget us, why we cannot forget? But this is the thing that we cannot forget. So Gopi's lamentation, something like this, but not. This is perhaps a shadow of shadow of shadow, what I told. So Gopis are thinking like this. And they are only living there. They are keeping their life only. Why? That Krishna has told that he will come. This only asha, hope, only this. Otherwise, they will kill. They will die. But Krishna will also die in their separation. So they are keeping anyhow their life. They are burning in separation fire, but yet they don't want to die. And what Krishna? Krishna is happy there? Not happy there. Anyhow, Lalita can pacify Srimati Radhika. Don't weep. Krishna will surely come. But there is none to pacify Krishna that gopis will come. There is none friend like this in whole Mathura. So Krishna is alone. He is burning so much in separation fire. There is none to say. But here, Yogmaya, Purnima, Vrinda, Lalita, Vishakha, all are here. And they can separate their separation mode to each other. But in Mathura, that is why Krishna, what doing? He wanted to send money. He went to school. Why school? Krishna and Baldev were son of Yashoda. They cannot forget this thing. They came to Mathura. And when Kansa was killed, then Nand Baba was waiting outside of the town. That why Krishna and Baldev are not coming? Kansa had been killed. Oh, something perhaps it is the Sarayantra.
Conspiracy
of Yadav. Willingly they are not allowing Krishna and Baldev to come to me. After 2 days, he never took anything. He was fasting for Krishna, feeling so much separation. And Krishna and Baldev came in the night, after sunset. They sat on the left and right side of Nanda Baba. Nanda Baba is weeping so much. Krishna and Baldev saw that father is weeping. Why? Nanda Baba told that, oh, you have come to Mathura and you have forget me. Now you have perhaps had the new father and mother. They also become to weep. No father. You are only our father. But all here, all Jadavas, like Akrur, Uddhav, Ugrasen, all Devaki, Vasudev, they are telling that you are son of Devaki and Vasudev. And they demand, they don't want that I should come to you. If they are fearing that if we are coming to you, then we will never return to Devaki and Vasudev, and you will take me to Vrindavan. They are fearing. That is that they are not allowing to come. Then he told that, do you think that you are son of Vasudev and Devaki? Oh Krishna, I can do in dream even. Baldev Prabhu told that I can never dream like this. You are my father. Yashoda is my mother, Rohini is my mother, they are in Vrindavan. I know someone tell that you are son of Devaki and Vasudeva. It may be. But they are forgiven me from childhood. They never gave me a drop of milk, no love and affection to me. And I was separated from them. And you and Yashoda Maiya has nourished me, given milk. So you are my father and mother, everything. I cannot think that he is my father. So I must come with you, with Krishna, to Vrindavan. Nand Baba told that, now what she to do? Now you are so intelligent both. I think that I must go to Vrindavan and you should come to me. Baldev Prabhu may be here. Why? Because the son of Devaki's six has been killed by Kans. So Devaki has only one son, like Baldev. So if you are coming, then they may both die. I think it will be better that Krishna should alone come with me. Then Baldev Prabhu told, I cannot live alone. I must die. Don't separate from me. I will come with Krishna. Without Krishna, I cannot live a moment. Then Krishna told that, Father, listen to me. It will be better that for 2-3 days I should be with Baldev. And Baldev will be here. And after 2-3 days, all will be pacified. And then I should return. Then he become worried. Nanda Baba. But there was no other way. So he thinking, if I'm taking Krishna with me, then Baldev will come. And if Baldev is coming, they will all die. Then I will be like a butcher. All will tell that Ananda Baba is very cruel. So what to him? He became in dilemma. Krishna told that, oh, don't be. Don't worry. I will come very soon. And all will be pacified. So you should go. And he took so many ornaments, golden and so many garments, silken and everything. And he tightened in the chadar of Nanda Baba. And he was there. Oh, if I will take it all, then the mother of Krishna will tell, you have sold Krishna with these garments and ornaments, and you have come empty. How I can show my face in Braja? But he cannot refuse that I cannot take, because Krishna is giving. Anyhow, in the evening, nights, he anyhow returned. But what became of Yashoda? When he saw, oh, he became blind. He became so angry. And he told that, you have sold my son, and you have brought these ornaments and garments, and by this we will be happy. And he slept on the bed, never came from bed, weeping. Very pathetic was in Vrindavan. One day Yashoda Devi, in evening, in midday, in the month of hot day,
summer day.
Now like these days in India, Jeth Mas, Yashoda was taking some garments of Krishna, baby Krishna, his little float, his some marble calves, and playing instruments. He was taking in a cloth, and he was going anywhere. Any gopi came, Mother Yashoda, where you are going? Yashoda was like a dumb. He was not in a stage to answer, but even told, I'm going to my child. Where your child? No. I've heard that he is in Mathura. So I must go. I will not tell that Krishna is my son. I will go to Devaki Rani. Rani, you know?
Queen.
queen. I will tell that I want to be your dasi, your messer. I will clean your vessels, everything like a dasi. I will not take anything. Only in a day I can see face of your child, and I will be satisfied. So telling this, and he became, when we came to on the door, and he became totally repentant. So like this, daily, Yashoda was feeling so much separation that you cannot manage it. And what became of Krishna? Oh, all the Jadubansi, and Akrur, and all other, they had a meeting, and they decided that we should change the mind of Krishna. How? We should give him threat, and we should make in his mind that Devaki and Vasudev is your father, and you are Jadav. And he should be in that, and he should be sent to Gurukul to learn. And in the meantime, he will forget, because he is like a baby of 10 years or 12 years. He can forget. So made a click. And there was going to be sacred thread to Krishna and Baldev. They were?
Saved.
Oh, very beautiful. And then this kind of cloths were given to them. And then Gayatri Mantra was given to them. Sacred thread and sandalwood. Oats?
Wooden sandal.
Very beautiful, like Brahmachari. If Krishna and Baldev are Brahmachari, how beautiful they will. So, oh, very charming and beautiful. Then Gurudev gave this, then he told that, oh, he ordered that you should now go to at least five or ten houses, and you can beg some bhiksha for me. Oh, mother, give me some donation. Oh, mother, give. Oh, father, give me, like this. And then Gargacharj made his chadar like this, a jholi. And the Brahmachari took jholis. And dand also, like today, you use dand. Very beautiful dand also. Krishna was given crooked some dand, and Baldev Prabhu very thick and straight. And they were, now, Gurudev told that you should go to your mother and father first and take begging, and then to others. Now Krishna is thinking. He closed his eyes. Oh, my Gurudev had told to go to mother. But where is mother? Where is mother? No mother. My mother is where? She is in Vrindavan, Nandagaon. And he remembered that his mother has promised, oh, Krishna Baldev, when you will be given sacred thread, Brahmachari, and given mantra, then I will fulfill your jholi, begging, oh, with diamonds and so many, gold and everything. So Krishna was remembering, where is my mother, where? Oh, mother, he became too shocked. And in front of all, Devaki and Vasudev especially were ready to give some all. But they are not telling mother, mother and father to them. They are remembering Krishna to Yashoda. Mother, mother, mother. And he, both, especially Krishna, and he was rolling down on the earth. This was the situation of Krishna. Feeling so much separation, but there was no way, because he has to do so many pastimes. So from here begins pathetic scene, even in Mathura, even in Gaur Pramanandi. Tomorrow we will again. So try to realize. You can remember and chant Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
with the tears. Oh, what is these days of Krishna? And Yashoda Maya, always thinking, oh my dear child, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. In this way you should try to lament and feeling separation and chant Hare Krishna. You should remember Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Oh, be merciful to me. Oh, Pancha Tattva, be merciful to Oh, Nityananda Prabhu. That past tense we can realize and we can chant like this. And we can forget everything, all problems of world. Where is world? Who am I? Try to forget all. Then Krishna will come and he can wash your tears. He is so merciful. So you should chant and remember and this and going this. This is the process. To remember all these past times in such a way, when you are reading, oh, this is maker. For this Swamiji came. He was so merciful. He wanted to make qualified like this. But he saw that there are so many other desires, a jungle, so many things. So he began to cut them. He wanted to make it fertile. But he left something for me. How I can serve? So for his service, he left me and told that you should go and now you should tell. Now, among them, some are so much qualified. If they will hear, they will hear. Certainly some qualified for these things. And that is why I came. Nothing to gain, no money, no prestige, not quarreling with anyone, not to make any disciple. If anyone taking these views, all are disciples. Bako Begam, Manasa Krodha Begam, Jiva Begam, Dharupas. Etan Began Javishahe Tadhir, Sarva Mapi Mam Prithivise. He is actually Jagat Guru. Like Swamiji was Jagat Guru. His Guru Dev was Jagat Guru, Vishwa Guru. Three world he was Guru. And Rupa Goswami. So we are so much fortunate to be in this line. Try to remember this thing. Your all the neighbors and all the others are not so much dear than like this. They cannot help. So you can help them. You can nourish and support. But don't be entangled. You can do your some duty. But always think like this. And try to develop your Krishna consciousness. Gaur Prema. Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol.